Good morning to everybody. I'm Luisa Bielmi. I'm the technician of Defesa Attiva. First, I want to thank WWF and also Moritz for inviting us here. And second, I want to take only 5 minutes for my speech because I prefer that my sheep owner, sheep farmer, can tell her experience to you. Okay, so what is Defesa Attiva? Difesa Attiva is not a project, it's an association. It's an institution with a corporate bodies and rules. It was a device to put in touch farmers who has received livestock protection dogs during the project, by the project Life Mad Wolf. This project ended last year. And it took place in 2 countries, in 2 districts in Portugal and in the province of Grosseto, in the south of Tuscany, in Italy. Why in this province? Why in the province of Grosseto? Because it's very particular, this province. You can see the number. We have more than 1,000 sheep farms, only sheep farms, okay? And more than about 200,000 sheep. Even if in the last 10 years, sheep number has decreased. We have a very negative trend now. And meanwhile, the wolf number has increased. And also the number of the predation has increased. It was caused a deep conflict, a very deep conflict, between prey and predators, but not only, between humans. Humans who ate wolf and humans who love wolf. Well, in this specific situation, we work. Okay. Difesa Attiva has mainly 3 important goals. First, create a network of exchanging and monitoring life protection dogs, but also promote all the prevention measures, not only dogs, okay? And promote the local agricultural products and activities. Well, Difesa Attiva, all the members of Difesa Attiva are sheep or livestock owners, okay? And if you want to become a member of this association, you must have a prevention measure, dogs, fences, enclosure, or both, or all together. We do a lot of things for our dogs. We wanted to evaluate also the cost and reduce the cost of prevention measure. And so we signed a different memorandum of understanding. Okay, this is the dogs around Italy, our dogs. The memorandum of understanding with different goals, with the 2 national parks in Italy, Foreste Casentinese and National Park of Toscomigliano, in particular with the Wolf Apennine Center, and also with the project Pastures. But we signed it also memorandum of understanding with WWF in Italy. And thanks to the funding of WWF, we have a vet in our farms. And also we elaborate a project we call a volunteer project, okay? We have a volunteer inside the farm and they can share the experience with the farmer and so on. But also we have a very important agreement with a pet food company. The name is Almo Nature. And they gave us dog food for 1 year. Okay, this is our team volunteers, but what we do? We wanted to share with all the people our activities and also the problems that we have. And so we have a page on Facebook, on the social network, and we manage also a website. We are not alone now in Italy. There is another organization, another association in another region with the same name, Difesa Attiva Liguria. And the president is a livestock owner, okay? and the same, we have the same association in the Alps in Trentino. The name is different. Difesa del patrimonio zootecnico dai grandi predatori. It's so long, okay? ADPG, okay? But we want people talk about us, can discuss about our experience. So you can find an article on CDP News about us, on National Geographic, but also a scientific article. And what Difesa Attiva want to achieve? A balance. A balance between livestock and wolves, yes, but difficult balance. There is cannot a peaceful coexistence. Even if you have prevention tools, you feel alone. If you are a shepherd, you feel all the time alone. Some generally people on the social media tell us how to do. Put the dogs, the fences, or something like that. It's not so easy. Okay. So we communicate in the positive way our problems. And we wanted to tell you in this meeting that Difesa Attiva is you and us. Okay, this is my president, Francesca. Yes, okay. And she's not here because she is also a farmer and cannot be here during this period. Okay, I will introduce my Luisa, but I need, we have a problem, so we need Moritz now. Thank you.
Okay, my name is Luisa.
Okay.
Civil. Ah, sorry. My name is Luisa, I'm from the Mucceti farm, and but I will speak in German because my English is not.
Yes, so I will translate for you a little bit, but the main facts are in English on the slide, so I'll give you some supplementary information.
Okay. Unser Hof hat ungefähr 50 Hektar. Wir haben 150 Milchschafe, 100 sardische Milchschafe und 50 französische Milchschafe, Lacon, und machen ungefähr 22.000 Liter Milch im Jahr, die wir direkt in der hofeigenen Käserei weiterverarbeiten.
So that's the facts about Luisa's farm that she runs together with her husband. And you see all the numbers, all the figures on the slide.
Die ersten Probleme mit Angriffen von Wölfen hatten wir ab 2004, 2005. Und der Angriff eines Wolfes bedeutet für uns, nicht nur den Verlust eines Tieres oder zwei Tiere, sondern je nachdem, wie der Angriff stattgefunden hat, auch den Verlust unserer Milchproduktion. Weil Tiere.
So they've had the first wolf attacks in 2004 and the loss of livestock to the wolf also obviously means a loss in milk production.
Weil Tiere, die Todesangst hatten, ihre Milchproduktion reduzieren.
Okay, so also even the animals that weren't killed, but the others were affected because they had stress, and so the milk production of the animals that survived the attack went down as well.
Die ersten Male, als das passiert ist, waren wir komplett allein. Wir wussten nicht, was wir machen sollten. Wir hatten auch viele. Uns wurden viele Sachen erklärt, wir sollen Hunde in unsere Herde einbringen, das wäre das Einfachste. Aber
they felt very left alone when the attacks happened first. They were given some advice, for example, that dogs would work, but nobody really told them, this is something you should do because it will work.
Weil wir waren uns auch bewusst der Verantwortung, was es bedeutet, wenn wir Herdenschutzhunde in die Herde bringen, die nicht richtig ausgebildet sind.
They were quite aware that bringing untrained livestock protection dogs into a herd is quite a challenge, so that you actually need to have good dogs that are trained. They were aware of this.
Wir haben dann bis 2015, also 10 Jahre lang, unsere Schafe immer mittags von der Weide geholt in einen Zaun, in einen
So for 10 years, every day they would bring the sheep to an enclosure in the middle of the day, to protect it from the wolves.
Und abends wieder raus auf die Weide. Also nachmittags. Es ging nur wirklich um diese Essenszeit, in der die Schafe auch nicht draußen sein konnten.
Okay, so they had to do this twice a day. It was quite a lot of work to move all the sheep twice a day.
Und erst 2015 haben wir dann den Kontakt mit Luisa Vielmi hergestellt, die damals noch für das Live-Projekt gearbeitet hat. Und mit ihr haben wir uns in der Lage gefühlt, uns um Hunde zu kümmern und Hunde zu benutzen.
2015, they got in contact with the other Luisa got together and exchanged experience and got some good advice from Luisa on the use of livestock protection dogs.
So sind dann Ende 2015 Tex und Sago zu uns gekommen, unsere ersten beiden Hunde.
The first two dogs, Tex and Sago, came 2015.
Die werden umsonst abgegeben von anderen Schäfern und sie sind schon geimpft, wenn sie zu uns kommen, also wenn sie den Hof wechseln, ne, von einem Schäfer zum anderen. Sie sind entwurmt und sie haben ein Mikrochip.
So they didn't have to buy the dogs from other shepherds or breeders, but the breeders would give them away for free.
Yeah. Into the Defensativa.
Into Defensativa, into the association.
Dann hat das Training mit den Hunden angefangen. Das dauert über Monate lang, wo wir jeden Tag mit den Hunden auf die Weide raus müssen.
So they started training then 2016, and it's a very long process because you have to go out on the pasture with the dog every day and train them to be with the sheep, basically.
Und wir haben natürlich auch ein bisschen technische Hilfen. Wir haben dieses GPS-Halsband, mit dem wir halt auch gucken können, wenn wir nicht dabei sind, wenn die Hunde schon in der Lage sind, draußen alleine zu sein, zu gucken, wie bewegen sich die Hunde, wenn wir den ganzen Tag nicht da sind.
So as soon as they had the feeling the dogs were independent enough, they would get the GPS collars, and so they would track them from back in the farm and just see what the dogs were doing on the screen.
Mm-hmm. 2017 ist dann unsere Hündin dazu gekommen. Dann haben wir wieder von vorne angefangen mit unserem dritten Hund. Und nochmal mussten sie nochmal ausbilden und gucken, wie sie arbeitet. Und
with the third dog, Frida, a female, they had to train her all over again. So it's always a process that starts all over again to train the dogs.
Es ist immer wieder eine neue Aufgabe und eine neue a new invention. Und das ist Tex als erwachsener Hund mit seinen Schafen. Ein wunderbarer Hütehund, Herdenschutzhund. Und wir haben trotzdem entschieden, regelmäßig mit unseren Hunden auf die Weide zu gehen. Nicht mehr täglich, aber regelmäßig, einmal in der Woche, zwei Wochen, um zu kontrollieren, wie sie arbeiten. Weil wir leben in einer Gegend.
So that's Tex as an adult with the sheep, and although the dogs were integrated quite well into the herds, they would still go out there and check that what the dogs, how they were behaving, is the behavior that's appropriate.
Weil unsere größte Angst ist nicht der Wolfsangriff, sondern meine größte Angst ist die Leute, die meine Nachbarn, was und wie sich die Hunde mit den mit Spaziergängern, die Hunde dabei hatten, Fahrradfahrer, Jäger oder Pilzesammler, wie sie sich verhalten.
So her biggest fear is actually not the wolf, but how the dogs will react to her neighbors, to people walking there, to hunters, to people out there.
Mettere prima quella foto dove c'è la passeggiata, è possibile? Perché okay. Torna meglio?
No.
No. Ok. Das ist ein Schild von denen, die wir an den Weiden haben, wo Menschen vorbeigehen, wo einmal darauf aufmerksam gemacht wird, dass Herdenschutzhunde da sind und wie sich die Menschen verhalten sollten, wenn sie den Hund sehen.
Yeah, because they were worried about the dog-human interaction, they put up these signs, giving advice to the people how to react, how to behave when they encounter the dogs. So for example, as you see, don't ride the bicycle, have your dog on a leash, and also keep a distance when you are a horseback rider.
Wir haben mit der Hilfe von Defesa Activa es geschafft, unsere. Das ist eine andere Sache, die wir auch mit Defesa Activa machen, dass wir Erfahrungsaustausch mit anderen Projekten machen. Hier waren zwei Wissenschaftler aus Spanien da von dem Live-Projekt Piros, die geguckt.
So what's very important is that there is a knowledge exchange, experience exchange between different projects. So there were actually farmers from Spain coming to Tuscany and they were exchanging their experiences with the dogs.
Wir machen dann noch, um uns sichtbar zu machen, auch in der Region, kommen Schulen zu uns, wo die lernen, Käse zu machen. Es geht wir erzählen über den Wolf, über die Hunde, wir verarbeiten Wolle weiter in Kursen.
Okay, so they offer some trainings, also some experience for visitors. People can visit the farm and they show them how to make cheese, what they make out of the wool, and tell them about their experiences with the wolf and the dogs.
Okay. Und ich glaube, dass das ganz wichtig ist. Es ist wichtig, dass wir miteinander reden, dass wir dem anderen zuhören und lernen, auch die Sprache des jeweils anderen Lagers zu sprechen.
So either things, it's very important that we talk to each other, but also listen to each other and learn to speak the language of each other.
Weil ich glaube, dass das Grundlagen unserer Gesellschaft sind und eines friedlichen Miteinanders, und dafür ist die Defesa Activa das beste Beispiel.
So this should be the base really of living together in our society, and Defesa Activa really lives that that belief that you need to talk to each other, need to speak to each other.
Und das ist noch etwas, was wir organisieren. Wir organisieren Spaziergänge mit Lega Ambiente, das ist eine Umweltorganisation, und Terra Madre, das ist eine Touristenorganisation, wo wir informieren, nochmal die Schilder zeigen, wie man sich verhalten soll. Und diese Zusammenarbeit ist sehr wichtig, damit wir mehr Visibilität bekommen.
There's a good cooperation with other organizations, with tourism organizations, NGOs, and they offer field trips together, where everybody can join and learn about the environment, about the wolf, about the sheep, about livestock protection.
Okay, thank you.
Thank you. Thank you very much.
Thank you.